Look, that's what I bought. Movie big head. Look, that's what I bought right there. With Mr. Antonio. This is my new car, guys. What's up, guys? It's your girl, Liz, and I'm coming at you from my new car. So, today I announced the ladies looking at me. That's exactly what's happening. Hold on. Now I feel insecure about what I'm doing. Can I help you? No, I don't want to help you. Oops. Okay, guys, so the person next to me was staring at me, talking to you at that last light, and then my dad ended up calling me. So I don't remember what I had already said, but this is my new car. I will have a little detail clip right here of, like, you know, the details of it. I already did the outside, but I'll show you guys the inside now.
Inside where all the green's at. Maybe like a little cup holder area across the dash.
I like this little cubby. This cubby's cute.
And the cubby over there.
And I am going to just throw this in with the Rolling with the Homies. I'm not going to do a whole update video on this because I already did a life update video in the past 2 months while all of this crap was going on. 2 months ago yesterday was when Arslan wrecked my vehicle. And, well, that sounds really, like, you know, angry, but I wasn't saying it in any specific sense. But yesterday was 2 months since we have been sharing one car. We both quit our part-time jobs, and we have been, you know, in the process of buying this home. So now, alhamdulillah, I am pleased, so pleased and blessed and thankful to say that today we went and we bought, we had our 100% go. From our mortgage lender to go ahead and go buy a vehicle. So we bought a 2013 Chevy Spark, and I am so, like, in love with this car. It is so quirky. The color is jalapeno green, and it's just so small and so odd looking, and this bright green color. Like, I don't know if you guys can see it right here. On my siding here, that there's that bright green, but I'm so excited, guys. It is supposed to be my day off, but I got called into work for a couple of hours, and I have no problem with that, because another reason why I just went and bought this car today is because my mortgage lender told me that everything came back from the loan department, and we are 100% clear to go to settlement on our house tomorrow at 5:30 p.m. So I'm extra excited about that. We're already set to close for the house at 5 o'clock last Friday, but something happened with the underwriters and my lender was on vacation, so some things just actually ended up taking a couple more days than we thought. Thought it was going to be yesterday on Monday, but now it's going to be tomorrow on Wednesday. Today is Tuesday. I bought a car. I'm going to work. It's been a wonderful day. I'm truly blessed and truly excited that after this small, like, crunch time period and, like, lesson learning period of my life of having to share one car with Arslan and being in the home buying process and only having one car is just really stressful, because I could go get a car if I want at any point, but do I want my house, you know? So I'm just so thankful that everything came together today and tomorrow, and then we move in August 1st, which is 5 years of us being together, and everything is falling apart. Everything is falling together, and I have my new car, and whatever song is on the radio, we're gonna jam out to right now. So for some reason my radio is, like, really staticky, so I'm gonna have to look into that, considering this is a brand new car. Anything that's wrong with it, I always get super paranoid, because not me. Like, I'm not trying to be the one to buy a lemon, you know. And of course, guys, all of my stations are still blurry, so I'm pulling up to work, and I will holler at you guys later. Oh, also, update, if you haven't noticed, let me point it out, because it's all I'm noticing. I had my nails done mint and gold, and then I painted them black, and then the same day I painted them black, I broke my poor little pointer finger off. So the claws need to be done soon, and that will be another update after these two crazy months of being stressed and worried and crunch time at work, like, working my butt off. I'm excited. Catch ya. What up, what up? It is a beautiful Wednesday morning. I just left the kind of orientation open house thing for the new school year with the school board for substituting, and I'm on my way to go pick hubby up to go do a final walkthrough of the house before we go to settlement. So we got a lot, couple of things that we're going to get done today. We got the walkthrough. I have to do my state inspection for my vehicle, as well as hopefully getting the windows tinted after that. And then we have the settlement at 5:30 this afternoon. So hopefully I got some good milestone footage for you guys today. And I hope you enjoy watching me become a real doll that owns a real house. Anyways, back to my music. I gotta really get used to the shape of my rear view mirrors because it's like a cute little triangular geometric shape. I can't see shit right now, but I really need to get used to it. Plus, I usually sit back more. That's one fact about me. I always sit back really far. Like, I don't know if you can tell when I'm in the car, but like, I'm like a whole arm's width away from my steering wheel, and I'm really small, so that's very far. I put lotion on my bug bite this morning, and now it itches. Best song to listen to right now. First off, it's very politically correct. Well, not like politically correct, but it's very politically current right now. And especially for myself, because things are going to get brighter. I finally closed on my house. I got my new car back. I'm starting my vlogging again. And the moving experience and the decor experience, I'm very excited about all of that. So things are going to get easier. So I went shopping with Kelly for the first time yesterday. We went to a couple of furniture stores and just kind of previewed furniture, I guess. I don't know what's out there. I don't know how they sell them. Now that I've gotten some of that browsing done, I got just like one thing for my office. And I need to find a carpet for my living room. I need to find a carpet for my office. I need to find furniture for my living room. I need a couch. I need end tables. I need a coffee table. And then I also need a whole bedroom set. So we'll see what happens with all of that. My next day off, I'm going to actually go on a thrift round of all of that. I want to see if the thrift store has any nice curtain rods, maybe some throw pillows depending on the store, maybe some hand towels for the kitchen since they're going to be pretty dirty, maybe some kitchen decor, because this one thrift store that I go to has like a huge kitchen section for like any and everything you need on your kitchen counter. Other than that, there's nothing else really new. I'm going to finally be gym life again because I have my car back and I'm not sharing cars and picking up each other from work and everything. I'm going to get off. I will get off at 6 o'clock today. And then I'm going to go to the gym, tan, get my back massage. But I'm also going to go home and change first and get my shoes on. I'm going to actually do some stretching and some walking, a little bit of workout to ease myself into it. Because to be honest with you guys, I'm kind of small and frail and not strong at all. So I really need to get back into just being generally healthy and fit. You know, I'm not really trying to like lose weight. People just need to be fit. This is what he does when we come furniture shopping. This place is so much better than the place we went yesterday. so much stuff.
It's huge.
Probably getting bedroom furniture today.
Hopefully. What's up, guys? It is a little too early in the morning for me today. It's like 8:30. No, it's like 8:20. And I'm on my way to work. I've had so much anxiety for the past couple of months, and especially for the past couple of weeks, over the house and not having a car and trying to make sure we save up and have enough money, trying to write lists and plan of everything that I need for the move-in. All types of stuff is just on my mind. Stuff with my father has been on my mind. Stuff with my mother has been on my mind. I've had a lot of stuff about my mother and father on my mind lately. My nanny, my mother's mother. I don't call grandma, she's my nanny. Nanny hasn't been doing too good lately. She's been in and out of the hospital for about 2 or 3 years now. She's been diagnosed with congestive heart failure. She's also been diagnosed with COPD. She is on an oxygen tank pretty much 24/7. She has a sleep app machine. Is this motorcycle still right here? Yeah, he is. So, hashtag prayers for Nanny. A lot of motorcycles on the road today. Like this video if you think I should get a motorcycle. I do have a bit of weight lifted off of my shoulders because I bought my bedroom. I'm sorry, guys, because I sound so terrible. But as I was saying, another weight lifted off of my shoulders was that I bought my bedroom furniture. It's a 6-piece set, and I can insert like a little clip right here. So hopefully that will be delivered on the third day that we will be moved into the house. So the walls I want to be painted, there's like 3.5 walls that I want to be painted. No, well, it's like 4 walls that I want to be painted throughout the house. When we go on the first of the month to sign, well, I never really told you guys much about the rest of that. I bought my house on Wednesday. You guys will see that little vlog when we went to settlement, and get ready for the move-in vlog. So when we bought the property, we also rented it back to the current owners for the rest of the month because they're getting a house built. So a rent back situation is apparently very similar nowadays. Instead of like arranging a certain date like previous or like prior to settlement, they can do a rent back, and you know, you can start it on the beginning of the month either way. As soon as we sign that paperwork and they leave, we go upstairs and start painting that master bedroom wall because it's pink. I'll be able to show you guys in the vlog, but it's pink right now and I'm not doing it. So we're at least gonna make that wall white unless I change my mind until we get to it. Because I haven't talked to you guys like this in like 2 months. Like, alright, well, I guess that's it for now because I feel like I'm just rambling. Nowadays, when I'm vlogging for you guys on my way to work, I kind of just go into autopilot and get to work. I'm not even paying attention to the road, so not very safe, guys. I'll catch you later. No, I wasn't scratching my butt. I have hair in my shirt back here somewhere. I don't know if you can hear me over the wind, so let me roll her on up. Just got off work a little bit early today. It is 4:30 on a Saturday. OMG, what do I do with all this free time? I go get these claws fixed. That's what I do. Oh, am I going to do my day off routine
this afternoon, since I have the time, I'm going to go get my nails done. I'm going to go to Planet Fitness and do my tanning and my back massage. And then I'm going to go to the mall and get my rings clean. Send my ring in for repairs because I need to get the soldering redone because it's starting to separate. The lady swore to me that it wasn't separating, but the lady at the store swore to me that they weren't separating, but I know better because first off, I've had it on my hand for like a year and a half, and I do hair, and it hasn't started pulling one or two individual strands of my customer's hair until lately. So it's definitely, oh no, hold on, my engine light is on my new car, hold on. Okay, so I called my husband to tell him that my engine light was on and he didn't answer. But now I really don't feel like vlogging. Oh my god, I just pulled up next to that big ass mobile home. I didn't even notice it. Thanks, dude. I have to get over slow because my car has no pickup. Anyways, that just kind of blew my day and I don't feel like vlogging anymore. I'm gonna try and figure out why the hell my engine light's on. I swear, I look worse and worse every time I turn this camera on nowadays. This angry fella on my face is finally starting to go away. But I finished my nails. I know this person is not trying to rush me across this fucking street. This car is kind of scary driving in the rain and stuff. Our salon really didn't want me to buy it because it doesn't have any pickup, but it kind of doesn't have. But yes, I got my nails did. I got them in a coffin shape this time. In a rose pink color. Good morning, guys. Welcome to today on Rolling with the Homies, where I sound like a mess and I feel even worse. I don't exactly know why, but I woke up this morning at 6:00 in the morning and my head just feels like crap. Yeah, this lip gloss is definitely not one to be doing in traffic, so I will go ahead and ride around with a half lip. See, that's what this one does. Like, I don't know if you guys can see. I'll show you in a minute. That gun is loaded, but it's not in my hands. I'm not the fire's lip. I'm not the one with the match yet. That gun is loaded, but it's not in my hands. Another boy's could never reach you. How could I have been the one? I saw the world spread beneath you, scattered like ice from the spoon. It was your world. Thing on Saturdays where it's like, you know, obviously it's acoustic music, so that's why this is a good song. It sounds kind of choppy right now. This is that Winky Luxe liquid lipstick matte lip gloss something. I don't know what the hell it's supposed to be. It says for people that aren't lipstick lovers, and it definitely does not feel like lipstick. When it goes on your lips, it's dry as hell. I'll catch y'all on the flip. Will I go furniture shopping? Will I still sound like this? Will I go home and go back to sleep? We will see.